Now let's take a look at another nice performance trick, compiling our PyTorch models to squeeze out even more performance. So what does compiling PyTorch models mean? So here's an overview of the three compilation steps that are involved. So the first step is graph acquisition. That means when we write our PyTorch code, the program will acquire our graph or construct our graph based on our code definition here. The second step then is graph lowering. In graph lowering, we take this graph and represent it slightly differently using simpler operations. And then after lowering the graph, we can then compile the graph to make it run on our hardware, for example, the CPU or GPU. So here's an example from the PyTorch 2 presentation to make this a little bit more concrete. Note, in this class, we are not going to talk about graph compilation in detail. However, I will share some additional resources with you. Now, the nice news is that we can simply call torch.compile on our model, and most of the time, this will result in a nice performance boost. So in the next video, we will see how this works in practice with a concrete code example.